Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. So, continuation po tayo ng discussion natin with your course sa personal identification techniques. So, specifically, with the topic rules in identification. So, there are four rules in identification that investigators, examiners observe in the conduct of their profession, being a investigator and or examiner. The first rule is the law of multiplicity of evidence in identification. So when we say law of multiplicity of evidence, it refers to the number of points of similarities and dissimilarities of two persons being compared, or two things being compared, wherein the number of similarities and dissimilarities has greater possibility for the conclusion of positive and negative identification. So, if there are numerous points of similarities, the conclusion would be positive identification. While certain number of points of dissimilarities would create or would give you negative identification. So, this is the law on multiplicity of evidence. So when we say points of similarities and dissimilarities, these are the this has something to do with the characteristics that are present to a person, including the height, the weight, the mole, its location, the scars, the tattoo, and so and so forth. So this evidence or as characteristics can be found to a person is being compared to the characteristics that can be identified from a person who were found, maybe found dead or alive, comparing to a person who is allegedly missing, or who is allegedly dead. And the information, the characteristics that are needed can be provided by the next of kin, the friends and colleagues of the person, or maybe by providing a photograph or a picture of a person who is allegedly missing. And then, of course, these characteristics that can be identified through the picture and through the verbal description of the next of kin, the friends and the colleagues, can be compared through the found dead body or a person who is alive. So just comparing the characteristics. Okay, the second rule is the value of the different points of identification. Take note, this value affects the formulation of conclusion. Considering that the person is missing and there is allegedly a person who is found dead from the river banks. So, one of the point of identification is the presence of tattoo at the back. And then the found person, the found dead body, also has tattoo at the back, but of different position, different position and of different size. So although they have the same tattoo, or they have the two persons, allegedly the one who is allegedly missing and the one who were found, as to the description, they have both tattoo, but the specific location at the same time of the size are different. So in the formulation of conclusion, there would be a different conclusion, or there would be a negative conclusion for that. That is why the different points of identification could affect the formulation of the conclusion. Okay. And number three, the longer the interval between death and examination of the remains for identification purposes, the greater the need for experts in establishing identity. Okay, if there is the several days of interval from the death of the person or the examination of the remain, between the death and the examination of the remain, of course, there would be a situation that the dead body started to decompose, or some of the part of the body can be mutilated already, or it is already been eaten by maggots, and discoloration appears, decomposition also started. Okay, so in these cases, the experts needs a greater expertise, and of course should conduct a thorough full examination, and they should have to act more faster, deeply, because they need to focus and they need to prove the cause, the time, and the niche, the factors that surrounds the death of the person. So take note, greater expertise is needed in order to establish the identity of a dead or a dead body, most particularly if there is an interval between the death and the between the death and the retrieval of the remains. And lastly, of course, if the evidence found are highly perishable, madaling masira, madaling mawala, of course the examiner, the investigator, should act the shortest possible time. Why? Because this physical evidence or scientific evidence might perish, diba? And of course the value, the probative value of this evidence might lost. Okay, again, those are the four rules in identification. Okay, kindly watch and like this video. Thank you very much and good day.